All right, yes, the fog's going to last through much of the morning. Mid-morning, we'll start to get some clearing out there, and we are going to see some sun before it's all said and done for today. And if we see ample sunshine, guys, those temperatures are going to hit records as we go into the afternoon. If we do have more clouds trying to hover, then I think that we may stay a little bit below that. So we'll see how it all turns out. I'll let you know by tomorrow. Visibility, it's a problem because of that fog. We can see that it is well reduced and not looking good. We have the big old goose eggs right now around Parkton, Westminster, Columbia, this morning. Even Annapolis now is at zero. Across the Eastern Shore, we do have plenty of school delays because of that fog. Right now, we don't have any dense fog advisories, but just because you don't have a dense fog advisory doesn't mean that that fog is not really causing problems. So just to take it easy, put a lot of distance between you and the vehicle in front of you as you're out on the road this morning, and make sure you do have those low beams on. The satellite and radar are not going to pick up on a whole lot of clouds, and if we do see the clouds, it's not going to be the type of clouds that will produce rain for today. So we are going to stay dry. I can't say that though as we head off towards the south in Florida, as we are looking at Tropical Storm Eta right now. It's just off the coast of Florida, southwest Florida, and strong winds now. Heavy rain and dangerous storm surge definitely occurring in portions of South Florida. So this is what we're going to contend with as we go through the rest of today. But then this thing will continue to push on off to the west northwest at about 13 miles an hour. And you can see the track as it is goes in the Gulf of Mexico, and then it works its way on off to the north and east. So Georgia is going to be under the gun pretty soon as well. And we are going to get in on some tropical moisture in the days to come. So our dew points are going to go up. We have a cold front that's going to move through the area as well. So with that, we are going to get plenty of rain in here. Temperatures this morning are above average, as we do have that area of high pressure still in control of our weather, and it's situated more off towards the east. That will be the trend over the next several days. And with that, we're going to continue to have temperatures above average, even as we work our way in through your tomorrow. And even as we work our way into Wednesday, Wednesday is the day that we will get all that rain in here. But again, it is going to be muggy on Veterans Day, and then we still could have a few showers around as we head into the end of the week as well. Let's go check the traffic with Lauren.